Dear students, today we are going to discuss about the third measure of central tendency, mode, meaning and its calculation through Sugan economics. Dear students, in the previous classes we have discussed about under measures of central tendency, arithmetic mean and median. So today we are going to discuss about the third measure of central tendency, mode. So here mode is a positional average. So here first we discuss about what do you mean by mode and what are its types. Then we will discuss about the calculation of mode for individual, discrete and continuous series. Right? So now you take mode. Mode is the value which occurs more number of times in a given series. Are you clear? Mode is nothing but the value which comes more number of times in a given series is called mode. So it means the value which is repeated more number of times. Are you clear? So mode is the value which occurs more number of times in a given series. Suppose if one value is repeated, that means we are telling it as a unimode or single mode. But there is a chance for repeating more than one variables or one values more number of times and equal number of times. So if there are two values repeated more and equal number of times, then we call the series as bimodal series. That means here there are two modal values we are having and we have to locate that also, right? Suppose in a given series, if three values are repeated more and equal number of times, so here the series is said to be trimodal series. It means here we are having three modal values. Are you clear? Unimode, only one value is repeated more number of times. Bimode, there are two values which are repeated more and equal number of times. And trimode, so here three values are repeated more number of times and equal number of times, right? Okay, so now I will explain how we can calculate mode for individual series. Already I have explained about how the structure of individual series is looks. So here I will explain how to calculate mode with the help of individual series, right, with the help of an example. So here you take example. So here suppose marks 60 65 70 60 62 and 60. So right, so here marks is given. So what is the first step we have to do? Means first we have to arrange the given series into ascending order. So now you arrange the series into ascending order. So under ascending order, it starts from lower value to the higher values. So here according to our sum, the lower value is 60 60 62 65 and 70. So now we have arranged the series into ascending order. Now you can look at the ascending order series, which value is repeated and more number of times. So here in the given series, 60 is repeated 3 times. So mode equal to 60. So mode equal to 60. Mode equal to 60 marks. Mode equal to 60 marks. So here there is only one value is repeated 3 times, that is 60 is repeated 3 times. So 60 is called our mode. So here it is unimode or single mode, right? Now I will explain bimode. So here the sum is marks 42 24 28 42 35 24 28 24 and 42. So now what we have to do means we have to arrange the values into ascending order. So here you arrange the values in ascending order. So here in ascending order, first you take the lowest value. So here the lowest value is 24. So here 24, again 24. So again 24. Then you take 28. Again you take 28. Then 35. Then 42. Again 42. Again 42. So now here we have arranged the values in ascending order. Here you can see that the 24 is repeated 3 times, 28 is also repeated, but it is repeated only 2 times, and 35 is not repeated, and 42 is repeated 3 times. So now more means the value which occurs more number of times. So here you take under unimode, one value is repeated more number of times, but under bimode, two values are repeated more and equal number of times. So here in the series, three values are repeated, but 28 is repeated only 2 times, but 24 and 42 are repeated more than 2 times, that is 3 times. So here we are having two modes, that is the first mode is 24 and the second mode is equal to 42. So mode equal to 24 and 42. So here there are two modes, so because of that only we are telling this series as a bimodal series. So in the same way, suppose if three values are repeated, so we can identify three modal values, and that series is called trimodal series. So for example, here you take the price is given. Now you have to arrange the price value into ascending order, right? So now what is the lowest value here? The lowest value is 33. So first you write 33 is repeated, again you write 33, and again you write 33. Then the next value is 36. So here 36 also repeated, 36, and here 36. Next 37. Again you take here 37, and here also you are having 37. Then the next value is 40. So here 40. So here you can remember 33, 36 and 37 are repeated 3 times, right? That is 3 times equally. All these 3 values are repeated 3 times. So here we are having 3 modal values. One modal value is equal to 33, and another mode is equal to 36, and another mode is equal to 37. So here mode equal to 33, 36 and 37, right? So here there are 3 mode values we are having. So this series is called trimodal series. For example, this is for the individual series. So I have given 3 examples. One example is for single mode or unimode, and the second example is for bimode, and the third one is for trimode. So now I will explain how to calculate mode for discrete series. So here we are having 2 methods. One is inspection method and another one is analysis method. Here I will explain only the inspection method. By way of inspecting the values, it is possible for you to locate the modal value. Suppose here you take marks, it should be taken as x, and number of students, right? So under marks you can write 40, 50, 60, 70 and 80, and the number of students here you take 5, 20, 40, 30, 10. So here how you can locate mode? On seeing the frequencies, which is the highest frequency, you can locate first. then the corresponding x value is your modal value. So here, according to our sum, the highest frequency is 40. Highest frequency is 40. So the corresponding x value, that is 60, is called our modal value. So this is by way of inspecting method we are calculating. So first you can locate the highest frequency and the corresponding x value is your modal value. So here mod equal to 60 marks. Mod equal to 60 marks. So in this manner you can locate mod for discrete series, right? So far I have explained about how, what do you mean by mode, what are the types of mode, there is unimode, bimode and trimode, and I have explained how to calculate mode for individual series and discrete series. Thank you. Dear students, mode is a simple concept. You can go through the video and clearly understand and study well. Those who are not subscribing to Sugan Economics so far, kindly subscribe and click the bell button, then only you will get intimation when we are uploading the video. Thank you, friends.